Hey everyone, and welcome to the second part of our exploration of stack smashing protection on macOS. To recap, in the first episode, we've seen how stack smashing works and various flags. Stack protection is enabled by default, but it can be disabled manually for various reasons. We've also seen how the fortify source flag causes replacement of risky functions like string copy with safer alternatives which check for the destination buffer size before copying, thus making sure buffers are not overflown. In this part, we'll take a high-level view and use Ghidra disassembler. We'll compare the binaries generated in the previous episode in parallel and make some notes. So let's start by compiling them again and generate three versions. The first one has all the checks enabled. The second one will have stack protector disabled, and I'll add the minus no sp prefix. Finally, the third one will have fortify disabled as well. All the three binaries should be completely different. We can verify this by generating their checksums. You can see all three are different. In Ghidra, let's first create a new project, non-shared project, which will be named Stack Smashing. In this project, we will import all the three binaries. Ghidra recognizes the file type. Before importing it, it does a preliminary check. More checks can be done later via plugins. We'll analyze it thoroughly later. We could have also imported this automatically by running Ghidra in headless mode. In this case, the quickest option is to load them manually since we only have three files. Let's see. Load the third one and we're almost done. When we open the first one in the code browser tool, Ghidra offers to do an analysis for us. Thanks, Ghidra. Look here, it has a lot of analyzers already enabled. Accept the default settings and analyze. Let's look at the functions and locate the main function. It's named here entry. Look at this. By default, Ghidra does decompilation also, hugely useful feature. This actually shows what we've seen before, but in a much nicer way. We've looked at this assembly code before, but now it's easy to see what's happening. A stack guard reference is located at the beginning of the main function. Another check at the end, which fails if the stack is in an inconsistent state. We will explore more deeply in further episodes how the stack check function works. Also, notice string copy check function, which replaces string copy. Since we're here, let's play a bit with Ghidra. We can change the name and type of the parameters and make the code nicer. You can see here that parameter param2 is type long, a conversion to undefined. This is unclear. We know how the code looks like. We have an array of strings from which we take the first element and copy it into a buffer. Let's reflect that here. First, we can rename the parameters. We know the second one is argv. And the first one is argc, the arguments count. Next, we'll check how they are used. argv is used here, and we also can correct its type. We know that it's actually an array of strings. Now, the code looks pretty similar with our original source code. This is the first element of argv. The additional parameter here, 16, is actually the size of the data to be copied. That's derived from the definition of the destination buffer. Rename it to buff, as we had in the source. We can also change its type, but it's not that relevant now. Play around with the variables and discover other ways to beautify your decompiled code. Param1, the arg count, is not used, so its type doesn't matter that much because it's not used here. These parameters over here relate to stack guard checks. Let's open the second binary now. The one we compiled without fortify. Analyze it automatically as before. Now, the main function doesn't have neither the stack protection checks nor the safer string copy function. It's the plain unprotected, unoptimized code. We definitely don't want this one. Let's check the third one, the one without stack protector, but with the fortify checks. Although we don't have the stack guard checks, the string copy function has been replaced. Let's see how to use the function comparison tool in Ghidra. Take, for example, the first binary, go into the main function, select some instructions, and then click compare selected functions, and Ghidra opens the function diff tool. At first, in both sides, we have the same function from the overflow binary. To add another function, open the second binary, let's take the one without stack protection. Then, go back to the comparison tool and add another function. Add the same function from the second binary. We'll have both versions side by side. Now, it's a lot easier to compare and see what changed between them. We could have used the listing view and search for the differences, but the decompilation is better. We can add the third one as well by selecting it in the Active Browser tab. Then add it as another function in the diffing tool. Use the plus sign. We see all three binaries here. The one without fortify, compared to the first one, is totally different. I suggest you give Ghidra's comparison tool a try. This was very, very useful for me. If you have only minor differences, you could simply use the disassembly comparison. In this case, it was faster to look at the decompiled code and see what changed straight away. Ghidra has another useful feature. It has a program differences tools. We could use it to compare programs more like a versioned reverse engineering analysis. Try that too and let me know what you think. I hope you like Ghidra, and I also hope that the stack protection explanations were useful. To master this, try the examples on your own. You will for sure discover more things. One idea is to spend some time investigating the stack guard protection and see how it works under the hood. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next videos.